get ready to match the stars. Joey Bishop, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elizabeth Allen, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flynn as we play the star-studded big money match game 77. And now here's the star of match game 77, Gene Rayburn.
Hello, Johnny Olson, how are you? Thank you for joining us, dear friends. Let's say hello to our distinguished celebrities over here.
71 years ago.
71 years ago, you and I first met. My, we are well preserved, aren't we? Here we are, Match Game 77. It seems like yesterday that we started, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Doesn't it seem like...
When did we start, 73?
July 1st, 1973.
Oh, how is that possible?
Well, I think it's, as Charles says, it's like a social event. It's really like not a job, and we're getting paid. Don't get any ideas.
You're getting paid?
I'm getting paid.
You're getting paid?
Aren't you getting paid?
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 Paid? Oh, I'm sorry, I brought the whole thing up. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't.
Well, that's great.
Yes. Say hello.
I've been working all this time, and he's been getting paid.
I'll give you half of mine.
In other words, when Dick Dawson... I'm sorry.
Here we go with George Frederick and Barbara Zwelling. Okay. 4-2 the score. Current champ George Frederick has $8,450, and we've got a pretty good game going here. We'll see how it ends right after we see about this message. Here we go, round two, final round. Barbara, it's up to you.
A.
All right, last time you had B, Barbara,
yeah.
Didn't you? Now you want A. The inventor said, I just created a bionic old person. Now, you don't have to oil him. Instead, every day to make him run, you pour in a quart of blank. You don't play? You don't play. I just created a bionic old person. You don't have to oil him. Instead, every day to make him run, you pour in a quart of blank. You matched in the first round, you see. That's why you do not participate. All right. Good. Here we go. With Barbara Zwelling. The inventor said, I just created a bionic old person. Now, you don't have to oil him. Instead, every day to make him run, you pour in a quart of...
booze.
Well, here today and gone tomorrow. Or maybe gone today. Here today and gone today. Joey, what'd you say? She said booze.
Well, there was one word there, see? There was a secret word, right?
Yes.
The word run. What was the last part of it?
Yeah, you don't have to make,
make
him run.
To make him run, you pour in a quart of... prune juice.
Prune juice. All right, what do you say, Charles, what do you say?
Geritol.
She's looking for booze, and you've got to match Richard and Fanny in order to stay in the game here now. Richard, looking for booze.
Geritol.
George wins the sixth game. There you go again, George. And another tape. Barbara? This guy keeps knocking them off one after another here. You made a good try at it. We've got gifts for you together with our thanks for being on Match Game 77. Goodbye. So, George, you picked up another $100. You got $8,550 now. And again, you got a shot at the big money. Shall we begin?
We shall.
We shall. We polled a studio audience some time ago, here, perhaps in this very room. And we got their best response to this. Linda Blank. Now, remember, you get $500 if you match their most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and then $100 for the third. And let's see what answers will be suggested by these people here. Brett.
Linda Day George.
Linda Day George. You're booing Linda Day George?
No,
she's cute.
Linda Day George, she's the prettiest little thing you've
Charles.
Ever seen.
Charles.
The American actress, Miss Linda Lovelace.
And Joey.
Joey, have you got one?
Yeah, but it's unfair for me to be third all the time. You understand what
I
mean?
All right, Joe, I tell you what. Let's pretend we're just starting. Yeah. We're calling on you
number
first.
Number one.
Joe, you're number one. What do you say?
I would have gone with Linda Lovelace, Linda Day George, and then an actress from years ago, Linda Darnell.
Linda Darnell.
Those have been my three Lindas. I knew I'd work myself into a boo. I knew that.
Wait a minute now. You would not have been booed if you'd said Linda...
Don't say it.
I better not say it. It's up to him now to make a decision. You can say Linda Darnell, Linda Day George, Linda Lovelace, or give us one of your own if you have one in your skull.
Linda Lovelace.
Yay! I was going to say, Linda Lavin. She's Linda pretty Lavin. Popular now, isn't she?
Linda Alice.
Linda Carter?
Yeah,
Wonder
she's...
Woman? Wonder Woman.
Right, okay.
I don't know any of those folks.
He wants Linda Lovelace. Let's find out if she's up there. And if she's hanging around the $100 place there. Okay, Linda Darnell. There you go, Joey.
Boom!
Yeah.
Boom!
Let's see if Linda Lovelace is under the $250 response.
Oh! And it really
Linda
Big
singer.
Yeah.
Big singer.
Yeah, marvelous singer.
Oh, Svenska. Yes. Ah, yeah. One, the two, three. Okay. Let's see if we get Linda Lovelace under the $500 response. Yes, indeed we do. Had a studio full of 102-year-old Mr. Perkins there. They all said Linda Lovelace.
You know what it proves, don't you?
You're going to play for 10 times the $500 or $5,000, and we'll give you the money if you match one celebrity.
Richard.
Okay. He has
George,
made his decision.
How do you know about Linda Lovelace? Now, you're a man who's going to give your money to the church?
Yes.
Or to your parents?
Right.
Is there something about you we don't know, George?
Anything you'd like to say now, before the jury leaves the room?
Well, when I was over at UCLA...
Yeah. I'll tell you right now, we're not buying that story, George.
All right, here we go. It's worth $5,000. Listen carefully. Get your ESP going over to Richard, and this is it. Pen and blank. That's P-E-N and blank. Pen and blank. Okay. Now we need a response from you that will match him, and you get an additional $5,000. Pen and...
Pen and pencil.
One dummy is booing, everybody else is applauding. Now we'll turn to Richard and find out if you collect the $5,000 or not. He says pen and pencil.
It sounded simple, but there was pen and pencil, pen and paper, or pen and ink.
Pen and ink. Yeah.
Sorry, Georgia.
All right, George, you've picked up an additional $600 just in this game. You'll meet another player later. Right now, we want to meet these messages. Now let's all welcome Gwen Taylor. Yay! Cute, huh? Cute? Cute.
Thank you.
Where are you from, Gwen?
I'm from the San Fernando Valley.
Yeah.
I'm in Pacoima.
You're a what?
I'm in the city of Pacoima.
Pacoima?
Yes.
Okay.
Anything else you want to know?
Well, yeah.
Okay, I'll tell you. I'm a second grade teacher.
You are? I bet the kids love you.
Can I say hi to room 19?
Hello, room 19! Cool
it. I enjoy tennis and I love to horseback ride.
Like your opponent here, Gwen, you have beautiful teeth and a very friendly, warm smile, doesn't
Thank
she?
You.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, then we'll give you a chance to have A or B here.
I'd like A, please.
You want A, and good luck to Gwen Taylor. Here it is. George said to Marcia.
Yes.
Hey, Marcia, what happened to your face? And Marcia said, well, this morning I made a big mistake. Instead of using face powder, I put on blank powder. Instead of using...
Question. I'm bored with this whole question business. I'm tired of answering questions. I feel I'm under constant interrogation.
I'll pack your bag.
Okay. Everybody's ready, Gwen Taylor. George said to Marcia, hey, Marcia, what happened to your face? And Marcia said, well, this morning I made a big mistake. Instead of using face powder, I put on blank powder.
Gunpowder?
Gunpowder. That's good. By Jove, I think she's come up with a very good answer.
Well, I said baking powder.
Baking powder. That would make you a little puffy, wouldn't it? How about you? What'd you say?
I'm tired of being interrogated. I feel I'm under constant investigation. I'm bored with it. I can't stand it anymore. But I did say gunpowder.
Yes, you did. Thank you, Tallulah. Charles?
Flea powder.
Flea powder. Gunpowder is what Gwen Taylor is looking for. She said instead of using face powder, I put on gunpowder. Elizabeth, what do you say?
Well, I couldn't think of anything that could make a woman look worse than gunpowder.
Gunpowder, I do. Right.
That is a great answer.
That's
I'm
a good
sorry
answer.
That I didn't have. I have baking powder.
Baking powder.
Good. I'm glad. I did the same thing as Dick. Now I'm proud of myself.
Well, I made a mistake. Don't be proud.
Yes, I'm proud.
He's
I made
proud.
The same mistake as you made.
Don't fight, fellas. Now listen, you. She's
Regina,
looking for a little
I'm
gun.
From Santa Barbara, California, and I love swimming and hiking. Oh.
Now wait a minute. Your key light just went out. What happened here?
Just well, that's the Lord's way of saying you're through.
What's happened?
She looks better.
Are you trying to tell us something?
Let me ask you this. Is Mark Goodson still here?
Oh, dear me, we're in the dark. Please.
Let there be light.
Let there be light, and there was. Go, Fanny.
All right.
No. I'll tell you when to go. Gunpowder. Not bad for first round. How about that? You got a good opponent there. George, this is yours. Dull Dennis is so dull. I'll tell you how dull he is. His favorite thing on TV is the blank. That's how dull Dennis is. His favorite thing on TV is the blank. Okay. There are two or three really good choices here. All right, George, here it is. Dull Dennis is so dull, his favorite thing on TV is the blank.
The commercials.
That's one of the good... No, wait a minute. That's one of the good possibilities. That's one of the good possibilities. There are several others. Let's see if he gets any commercials here. Joey?
You got to remind me the next time I do this show, if I do this show again,
yes.
That I leave all my logic in the dressing room. Okay?
Yeah, right.
Because there's no place here for logic.
That's true.
I thought test pattern.
Test pattern is a very good answer, Joe. Well, you got the popular favorite with
yes,
the audience.
That's fair.
That's
when
right.
When I deserve to be booed, they yes. Boo, but when I deserve to be applauded. Yeah.
George blew that booed. One. You didn't blow that one, Joey. He did. What do you say? All the commercials not bad.
Tired of being under constant scrutiny. I said the farm report.
The farm report would be pretty dull. Charles?
That's a very snappy answer,
I
folks.
Said a very in bad taste answer.
Well, then.
The sermonette.
The sermonette. All right. Sermonette is what he said, but George Frederick said commercials. What do you say, Elizabeth?
Well, you see, I'm with Charles again. I said closing sermon.
All right. Favorite thing on TV is the commercial.
Test pattern.
Test pattern. Good answer. And Fanny.
Test pattern.
There we go. So at the end of round one, it's 3-0. Favor the challenger. Look at Gwen Taylor. How about that room 19? Aren't you proud of her? Let's hear it, room 19. Hey, here's a little commercial for everybody in room 19. Don't leave the room. We're ready to go to round two, the final round here. Gwen, you may have A or B.
I'd like B, please.
All right. Now let's see. She matched three people in the first round, Brett, Elizabeth, and Fanny. So isn't it funny? The three guys play. Three guys. Ready, guys? Here we go.
Okay.
The condemned man said, "My wife is wonderful. Tomorrow I'm being executed, so she knitted me a blank." There you go. That's it. All right, Gwen Taylor. The condemned man said, "My wife is wonderful. Tomorrow I am being executed, so she knitted me a..."
It's like it's a suit, but made out of wood, because wood doesn't, I don't know. I know.
Okay, room, I feel too bad, room 19, but you say a wooden suit.
Suit.
You would expect these people to say a wooden suit,
no.
Gwen Taylor? And you a college girl? What'd you say, Joey?
I say that room 19 ain't gonna show up tomorrow. That's what I say.
Right.
I said an electric blanket.
An electric blanket? Charles, what'd you say?
I was going to write a wooden balsam suit. It was on my mind.
Yes.
But I said blindfold.
Blindfold is the answer, isn't it? She knitted him a blindfold, right, Richard?
A full blind.
A full blind there. Now, George, here we go again. Three to tie, four to win. Frank said. Frank said this past summer I went to the Canary Islands, and guess what? The Canary Islands are covered with blank. Okay, now George Frederick. Frank said this past summer, I went to the Canary Islands, and guess what? The Canary Islands are covered with...
Canary Dew.
Some canary do and some canary don't. He says, Canary Dew.
Daddy Dew, whatever that guy's name. Daddy Dew, I never heard of canary. Doo-doo.
Doo-doo. There's one. Okay, Brett.
Doo-dah, doo-dah.
That's two. Three to two is the score. One more to tie. Charles.
Bird Dodo.
Tie score. One more wins the game. What do you say there, Elizabeth?
Well, I said bird droppings or doo-doo.
All right, what do you have, Richard and Fanny? Come on down.
Nice try.
Hello there. My goodness, this guy's won seven games now. Can you believe that? Seven games. Well, Gwen.
Thank you.
You had a little undoing there with your wooden suit.
Yes, I did.
A blindfold would have done it for you very well. Anyway, it was a pleasure to meet you in your room 19. I'm sure they're proud of you.
Thank you.
You're beautiful and a marvelous person.
Thank you.
Gwen Taylor, there she goes. Okay, there it is, George. We say we polled a recent studio audience, and we interrogated them, and we got their best response to this. Blank rod. Now remember, it's $500 for matching the answer they gave most frequently, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. And you may call on three celebrities of your choice.
Joey.
Joey.
Oh, first.
That's very kind of you to put him in number one.
He looks a little athletic, so I'd put fishing rod.
Fishing rod. Okay.
Richard.
The old curtain rod.
Curtain rod.
I said it first.
Okay.
You're afraid to boo him.
Charles.
Charles?
Curtain rod is a sissified answer. I've chosen a rugged, tough answer.
What's
mean
that?
And... Ramrod. The name of my new series.
Is that the name of your new series, Ramrod? So there, three of them. George, Ramrod, Curtain Rod, and Fishing Rod. You want one of those?
Lightning Rod. I think I'll try Hot Rod.
He got the hot rod going for him. That's what he wants. His own answer. He's on his own. He has rejected you. That's what he's done. He's rejected you, too.
However, if we're right, it'll be the first time in television history that an audience got canceled.
Right. We'll find out if we got a hot rod up there. Maybe we see the $100 number. Lightning rod. Oh. Let's see if we get a hot rod under the $250 number. Fishing rod. Okay, there's Joey's answer. He's sweating it out. Last chance for the hot rod. Here we go. Congratulations there. Now you got $9,650, and we've got this message for you. Attaboy. I'm Gene Rayburn. You may join us next time for Match Game 77. Goodbye. Okay. 4-2 the score. Current champ George Frederick has $8,450, and we've got a pretty good game going here. We'll see how it ends right after we see about this message. Here we go, round two, final round. Barbara, it's up to you.
A.
All right, last time you had B, Barbara, yeah. Didn't you? Now you want A. The inventor said, I just created a bionic old person. Now, you don't have to oil him. Instead, every day to make him run, you pour in a quart of blank. You don't play. I just created a bionic old person. You don't have to oil him. Instead, every day to make him run, you pour in a quart of blank. You matched in the first round, you see. That's why you do not participate. All right. Good. Here we go. With Barbara Swelling. The inventor said, I just created a bionic old person. Now, you don't have to oil him. Instead, every day to make him run, you pour in a quart of...
booze.
Well, here today and gone tomorrow. Or maybe gone today. Here today and gone today. Joey, what'd you say? She said booze.
Well, there was one word there, see, that was a secret word, right?
Yes.
The word run. What was the last part of it?
Yeah, you don't have to make it.
To make him run, you pour in a quart of...
prune juice. All right. What do you say, Charles? What do you say?
Geritol.
She's looking for booze, and you've got to match Richard and Fanny in order to stay in the game here now. Richard, looking for...
I'll tell you right now, we're not buying that story, George.
All right, here we go. It's worth $5,000. Listen carefully. Get your ESP going over to Richard, and this is it. Pen and blank. That's P-E-N and blank. Pen and blank. Okay. Now we need a response from you that will match him, and you get an additional $5,000. Pen and...
pen and pencil.
One dummy is booing, everybody else is applauding. Now we'll turn to Richard and find out if he collect the $5,000 or not. He says pen and pencil.
It sounded simple, but there was pen and pencil, pen and paper, or pen and ink.
Pen and ink. Yeah.
Sorry, Georgia.
All right, George, you've picked up an additional $600 just in this game. You'll meet another player later. Right now, we want to meet these messages. Now let's all welcome Gwen Taylor. Yay! Cute, huh? Cute?
Thank you.
Where are you from, Gwen?
I'm from the San Fernando Valley in Pacoima.
You're a what?
I'm in the city of Pacoima.
Pacoima?
Yes.
Okay.
Anything else you want to know?
Well, yeah.
Okay, I'll tell you. I'm a second grade teacher.
You are? I bet the kids love you.
Can I say hi to room 19?
Hello, room 19! Cool it. Wait a minute now. You would not have been booed if you'd said Linda...
Don't say it.
I better not say it. It's up to him now to make a decision. You can say Linda Darnell, Linda Day George, Linda Lovelace, or give us one of your own if you have one in your skull.
Linda Lovelace.
Yay! I was going to say Linda Lavin. She's Linda pretty Lavin. Popular now, isn't she?
Linda Alice.
Linda Carter, yeah, Wonder she's... Woman. Wonder Woman.
Right, okay.
I don't know any of those folks.
He wants Linda Lovelace. Let's find out if she's up there. And if she's hanging around the $100 place there. Okay. Linda Darnell. There you go, Joey.
Boom!
Yeah.
Boom!
Let's see if Linda Lovelace is under the $250 response.
Big singer.
Yeah, marvelous singer.
Oh,
really.
Svenska. Yes. One, two, three. Okay. Let's see if we get Linda Lovelace under the $500 response. Yes, indeed we do. Had a studio full of 102-year-old Mr. Perkins there. They all said Linda Lovelace.
Yeah. You know what it proves, don't
you? You're going to play for 10 times the $500 or $5,000. And we'll give the money if you match one celebrity.
Richard.
Okay. He has
George,
made his decision.
How do you know about Linda Lovelace? Now, you're a man who's going to give your money to the church.
Yes.
Or to your parents.
Right.
Is there something about you we don't know, George?
Anything you'd like to say now before the jury leaves the room?
Well, when I was over at UCLA...
Yeah.
Get ready to match the stars. Julie Bishop. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Elizabeth Allen. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flynn. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers.
Hello, Johnny Olson. How are you? Thank you for joining us, dear friends. Let's say hello to our distinguished celebrities over here.
71 years ago.
71 years ago, you and I first met. My, we are well preserved, aren't we? Here we are, Match Game 77. It seems like yesterday that we started, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Doesn't it seem like...
When did we start, 73?
July 1st, 1973.
Oh, how is that possible?
Well, I think it's, as Charles says, it's like a social event. It's really like not a job, and we're getting paid. Don't get any ideas.
You're getting paid?
I'm getting paid.
You're getting paid?
Aren't you getting paid?
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 Paid. I'm sorry I brought the whole thing up.
Either.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't.
Well, that's great.
Yes. Say hello.
I've been working all this time, and he's been getting paid.
I'll give you half of mine.
In other words, when Dick Dawson... I'm sorry.
Here we go with George Frederick and Barbara Zwelling. For booze, Geritol. George wins a sixth game. There you go again, George. Hand on the tape. Barbara, this guy keeps knocking them off one after another here. You made a good try at it, and we've got gifts for you together with our thanks for being on Match Game 77. Goodbye. So, George, you picked up another $100. You got $8,550 now. And again, you got a shot at the big money. Shall we begin?
We shall.
We shall. We bowled a studio audience some time ago, here, perhaps in this very room. And we got their best response to this. Linda Blank. Now, remember, you get $500 if you match their most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and then $100 for the third. And let's see what answers will be suggested by these people here.
Brett.
Linda Day George.
Linda Day George. You're booing Linda Day George?
No,
she's cute.
Linda Day George, she's the prettiest little thing you've
Charles.
Ever seen.
Charles.
The American actress, Miss Linda Lovelace.
And Joey.
Joey, have you got one?
Yeah, but it's unfair for me to be third all the time. You understand what
all right,
I mean?
Joe, I tell you what. Let's pretend we're just starting. Yeah. We're calling on you first.
Number one.
Joe, you're number one. What do you say?
I would have gone with Linda Lovelace, Linda Day George, and then an actress from years ago, Linda Darnell.
Linda Darnell.
Well, and then my three Lindas. I knew I'd work myself into a boo. I knew that.